Hello guys, in this quick video I'm going to show you how I remove the rubberized paint from a few devices in my house. Okay, so I've got this over the years on various things and it's annoying. Really annoying. I have no clue why it's still used when everybody knows that it turns into this gooey stuff. Why would you want that? Beyond me. Anyway, so this is a mouse that was some sort of a, not a giveaway, as a gift from the bank or whatever. It was really nice at first. Now look at it. I can barely touch it without getting annoyed and getting gooey stuff. So this is one of the items that I need to clean. The other one is this thermometer. I had to put it in a bag to be able to still use it because it's all gooey and gross. And another thing, this laptop, this one I just got. Actually, I got two of them. It had a sticker like that one has, the yellow one, with the specs of it, which was glued to this cover with scotch tape. And when I peeled it off, behold. And now it looks like crap with that hole in there. But I looked a bit around and even on the back, it's starting to peel off. I am not going to do anything to the back yet. It's not that bad and it's not something that you see every single day you use it, but this thing needs to be fixed. So you could try, I don't know, some use magic eraser or something like that, or alcohol or whatever. That is not going to do anything if this stuff is peeling off. It might just repair the surface a little bit if you just have scratches like this around here. But when it's peeling off, you need to completely remove it. And you cannot use, I don't know, paint thinner or something like that, because it will also damage the plastic underneath. So that is not really a solution. You need to do it the hard way, with force. But you need something that doesn't actually scratch the plastic. So metal out of the question. Next best thing, you can scrape away at this with a card. Yes, depending on how old this thing is, it might go easy, or you would need to put a lot of work into it. And from what I'm seeing at this very moment, in my solution, the part with a lot of work, yeah, I think that is what needs to be done. So let's get to it. We have a problem with this one. It is becoming unglued in certain areas, but overall this thing is not as damaged as I thought. So I want to remove it because I don't want this spot over here, but it will not be quite easy to remove. So I'm thinking I will use just a tiny bit of alcohol on it, so it soaks in a little bit and makes it more moist, more easier to remove. So let's see how that goes. Okay, as you can see, where I've moistened it up a little bit with alcohol, not paint thinner, just alcohol, it's way easier to remove. Where it is completely dry, you cannot remove it. It will just come off when it wants, where it wants, and annoy you. So the idea is to moisten it as good as you can. I'm going to try and use actually wet wipes, because those don't evaporate as quick as alcohol does. Yes, this card even will leave a few marks on this thing, but those will be removed with a bit of polishing paste like that at the end. So I don't even care, or I might actually decide to use really fine sandpaper really fine sandpaper to give this thing a matte look. Could do that. Not really sure. We'll see in the end. But now let's remove this whole thing because it's... Eh, why do they use it? I have no clue. Okay, as you could see, this time I have alcohol plus the stuff that is already on the wet wipes because I want to make the scraping as easy as possible. Just one thing that I need to point out, the more you take your time into soaking this thing, the easier it will be. But also make sure you do not put any of the alcohol inside your display. Because if you put that inside your display, you will have really bad spots and you might have problems using it like that. So really careful with this alcohol. The wet wipes themselves are way less dangerous, but when you also add the alcohol, yeah, you have a weird mixture. And do this in a well ventilated area. So let's get to scraping. Okay, you can see this square in the corner where no moisture could got behind it because the sticker was there. You can almost not remove it, or actually you fairly cannot remove it. So it's really important to get this thing as moist as possible. Yeah, I know how that sounds. Get over it. So we will continue. And yes, this is a really dirty process. Make sure you do it in an area that is easy to clean. As you can see, we are in an area where this thing sticks a little bit better, so it's a bit harder to remove than the rest. We will still get rid of it, no problems. Just takes a bit more time. And if you cannot start to remove it with, I don't know, wet tissues or just a bit of alcohol, I don't know, try to come up with ideas like hand moisturizer, I don't know, whatever, any sort of cream, maybe even engine oil, I don't know, but try it on a small corner and make sure it does not dissolve plastic. If that thing you are using dissolves plastic, you will get really bad marks on the plastic itself. You remove the ugly paint, you are left with ugly plastic. That's not a win-win. We need a win-win. Get rid of the ugly rubberized paint and remain with really nice plastic. If you do have small scratches, I have, I think, an area somewhere around here and maybe one around here where this thing actually managed to scratch a bit of the plastic. This is less strong than the plastic I'm working with, but if you put it in the right position, it still can leave tiny marks. So I will use just a bit of polish probably in the end. I don't think I'm going to make it look matte because I actually like how it looks like this shiny. So that will be my goal in the end. Okay, once the cover is finished, you can give the same treatment to the edges if you want, or you could leave them alone. Honestly, in my case, I'm going to try and give the edges the same treatment, but I've got no clue if this will actually succeed or not, and it will be quite tricky to film. And I think they are dry already, so I need to moisturize or whatever the correct term is once again. But I'm going to be extremely careful here because I can get alcohol in the display from the edges, and that would be the worst possible thing. Okay, in my case the edges are extremely well stuck into place, so only the top side and bottom side were affected by the aging process of this rubberized paint. I don't know, the edges really hard to be removed, so I'm just going to make a nice space between this and the place where there is still that rubberized paint, and I'm going to polish this whole thing up and do a bit of polishing right on the edge. So that should be really nice. If I could put moisture on the edge without the risk of going into the display, maybe I have a chance to remove it, but I'm not going to risk destroying that thing. I just want to make this look perfect, hopefully. So let's get to it. Okay, this is some polishing paste. I think it was a few dollars, and I have it already for a few years now and still using parts of it, and the tube still has some in. I've seen people use even toothpaste, but this does it way faster. Of course you could do it with a machine or something, but I'm not going to risk damaging this laptop, so let's do it by hand. Okay, the inside, as you could see, it's clean, no problems there. This, you might be wondering, what are those marks? Well, in the middle of each and every single one of these, there was an injection spot on the other side. So, because Lenovo knew they are painting over this plastic, they didn't really care about the plastic to be perfectly black, so it's not perfectly black, and as it sits right now, it's not extremely shiny, it's sort of matte. You can see these injection marks. Obviously with the light from the camera you can see them, actually for the camera, not from the camera, you can see them pretty badly. Now, there are a few options at this point. You got rid of the rubberized paint. You could use Plasti-Dip on this thing. You could use, I don't know, a clear coat over it. Many options. I'm going to try, as you could see, I tried to use this for furniture. Doesn't do any good in this situation. The best thing, I think, without paint involved, would be car wax, because that would create a really glossy layer, and the light will bounce in a completely different way and you will not see these things. But I don't have car wax at home at this point, so I'm going to try and use transparent shoe wax. The results, yeah, we will see them in a moment. Okay, this is what I'm going to use, and what this video teaches us until now. Can you remove that? Yes, you can remove the rubberized paint. How it will look after you removed it? Well, your mileage may vary, because you never know how the plastic looks underneath. Will this work? I have absolutely no clue, because obviously this is the first time I'm trying to do something like this. Probably I will do it, it will look even worse, but I will just take it off and go from there. Looks nicer, but we have these marks on it. I don't know, maybe I can get them out somehow. I'm going to try. Nope. Here to stay. So maybe I need to do something like this while this thing is still wet. Jesus, this is complicated. Okay, I think I might have an idea what went wrong. This thing dries up way too quickly for what I need. So I'm going to try and use this thing. This is way more, way closer to car wax, wax, whatever, than that thing is. If I would actually have any idea how to spread it. Ooh, I think it's actually starting to make a difference the first second I touch this thing. So let's get to it. First layer, this thing is already shining, and I do not care about the injection marks. It's actually a pattern on it. So if I can make this shine, perfect for me. Ta-da! This is the end result, and it's good enough in my book. Yes, again, you could potentially repaint this. My phone vibrating. Repaint this or put a clear coat on it or whatever. But with some sure shine, this is what I got. And again, this actually does look rather interesting and unusual. You might like it, you might hate it. But again, I will keep it this way. So yeah, let's continue with the other items that we need to get rid of the rubberized paint from. Okay, this first, I'm going to attempt to do this without opening it up. First thing that I need, obviously, tissue. And some alcohol. Let's do this in high speed because it will take a while. Ta-da! And it's done, and I couldn't be happier that I got rid of the that stupid rubberized paint. this thing fully usable once again. Awesome. It was impossible to touch it with that. I don't even want to remember this thing. Look at it, fully usable once again. It had a bag glued on top of it, so I could at least touch it and use it. Sadly, the plastic is cheap Chinesium and it's starting to crack, but I put some super glue on both sides, so yeah. But that has absolutely nothing to do with the removal of this rubberized coating on it. And the laptop itself, as you can see, shiny. So all you need, wet wipes. These are special for furniture, but maybe even hand wet wipes also work. Some alcohol. This is 99.99%. Some random pieces of cloth, and if you want to polish anything, transparent shoe shine, but the type that doesn't dry really quick. So the one with a sponge at the end, not good at all. If you have some car wax, that's even better than what I used, obviously. But this is what I have, so this is what I use. And yeah, it can be done. It's a lot of work. I hope they will stop using this stupid paint. It's nice to feel it when it's brand new, but in a few years it's really, 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 really bad. So yeah, this has been it, guys, for this video. I hope it helps you, in which case please give it a like, check out my other videos, subscribe to my channel, and as always, see you in the next one. Bye.